I think people will sit up and say, why is this meeting happening in Singapore? And they will draw their conclusions and they will see how things ran. And I'm sure that we will be able to show what Singapore can do. So I think it's a plus for Singapore. It costs some money to put up resources. It's a lot of effort for our security people. It's a lot of effort for our comms people as well. If you ask me how much it will all come to, I've seen Vivian was asked this question earlier. I would say plus or minus it's around $20 million. We may be able to recoup a little bit of that, but I think it is a cost which we are willing to pay, and it's our contribution to an international endeavor which is in our profound interest. I think if you calculate the price of everything in this world, you will miss out the really important things. And in this case, what is important is that the summit is held, and we are hosting it, not extravagantly, but with due consideration to cost, but making sure that the operational requirements are met. 这一次的准备比前一次喜马会规模比较大，纯粹是因为这一次会议的具体需求，因为这一次会议规模比较大，来的人比较多，媒体，单单媒体。 就已经2500名记者报名了，register。那安全方面的准备，这一次的需求也比以前喜马会和其他会议来得高，因为这一次会议是全球瞩目的，所以大家都要知道这个是什么一回事，会有什么后果。那 两边会达到什么协议？同时，这两边都是很，他们关系是很多年来都是很复杂的关系，所以在新加坡开会，必须一切都准备好，不能够让他自己去安排。 所以这次规模比以前大，我看是有它的理由，有它的具体理由，不是形式上的，但是是具体的。最重要的好处是，如果这次会议成功，那东北亚的地缘局势可以有好转，那朝鲜半岛的紧张局势可以放松一点，那这个朝鲜无核化可以逐步进行，那这个 对区域是好的，对新加坡也是很好的。因为如果东北亚发生紧张局势或者冲突的话，那波及的不只是东北亚的安全，而是整个亚洲，甚至是整个国际、整个世界的安全。所以我们在新加坡如果能够帮助这一次会议取得成功，我看这个完全是对新加坡有益的。